こんにちは、みなさん。For today's video, I've been looking through a lot of the concerns that people have shown in my channel, and they are expressing that a lot of times they're able to identify the meaning of a kanji, but that in regards to the phonetic portion, sometimes it can be a little bit difficult. So today I will be showing one of the ways that can be used to learn how to read a kanji.And that's why today's video is called Ideographic Radicals versus Phonetic Compounds. I'm pretty sure you're wondering what does ideographic radical and phonetic compound mean. Let's start with ideographic radical. These are the type of radicals that will help you determine what the meaning of the kanji is. It will kind of lay out a picture or an idea of what the meaning might be.On the other hand, we have phonetic compounds. Phonetic compounds are those found in the kanji that will help you determine what the own reading of the kanji is going to be. Now, let's start by looking at the very first example. This kanji right here means to engrave or to carve. If we look at the radical, the main radical for this kanji is sore.The radical for sore is a lot of times used like knives or sharp tools. So in this case, to engrave has a lot to do with a sharp tool, carving or engraving an object. That's how we see the relationship between the radical and the meaning of the kanji. For the next one, we have the kanji for sweating. This kanji has the radical for water.Water can be used a lot of times in regards to liquids. So sweating and liquid, that's how we have the radical for water in this kanji right here. For the last one, we have this kanji, which means liver. The radical for this kanji is the radical for meat or flesh.So definitely we see a lot of relationship between flesh and body parts or organs. So a lot of times you will be able to see this radical whenever it has some relationship with body parts. Now we can look at it once again and we see that the main radical has a relationship with the meaning. However, how about this compound right here?This compound right here comes from the kanji dry. What is the relationship right here? The main relationship is the own reading. The own reading for the kanji dry is kan, K-A-N, kan. And that reading is taken by all these three other kanji. These three, each one of them is read as kan.Just for the own reading. That is how the dry compound plays the role of the phonetic compound, while on the other hand, the radical for sore, water, and meat played the role of the ideographic radical. Now is homework time! Let's start by reviewing last week's homework. And last week's homework was, can you tell me what theOn and kun reading for the kanji of book was? The on reading is hon and the kun reading is moto. Usually hon is used to represent a meaning with books and moto is used to represent a meaning with origin. And now let's look at this week's homeworkThis is the kanji right here for this week's homework, and it means river. Can you tell me, by looking at the kanji, which one is the phonetic compound? Can you also tell me how will you read it? Please type that in your comments. If you like this video, please give it thumbs up. Also, subscribe to my channel. Share this video with other people that might be learning Japanese.And if you have any other suggestions or comments, type those out as well. Thank you guys and see you next time.